Today is the 11th day of new month. Heading up to 6 weeks. And all my thing I want to do now is get back to Abaco permanently to help with building my house and to help with my neighbors, etc. Going back yesterday was bittersweet, like always. I've already been back 3 times. But I want to show persons that I'm working with the government. I want to work with my member of parliament, Darren Henfield. He trolled the red carpet with me. I've accepted it. And I said, look at Darren, there's so much negative stuff that's going on. I could fill my video, fill up my contact with all the negative stuff. But give me some positive stuff that I could talk about that's happened in 5 weeks. There's a million negative reasons that your song say, I got a million reason to leave. But give me one reason to stay. Give me one reason. And I want a full Bahamians, Abaconian air with positive stuff. None of that negative garbage. We all in this together. That shows some maturity on my behalf because I could talk about all the negative stuff, but is that going to help anything? I just want not Abaco to be a rugged island. It seems like the same thing that happened in Rugged Island. 2 years later, we're going into 2 months and the same thing is happening. I know you can't call Abaco a green spot because the importance to the economics of this country, Abaco has to get back in order to put some money into the purse. So I want to show persons that don't give me this idea, am I going to run again? I'm going to vote for you. That is nonsensical. That doesn't do anything to me because y'all are used to the color of this shirt, not the contents of one heart. And after all I've done on the ground all my life, being the president of the Abaco Basketball Association, the biggest association in the country for 11 years, that my deputy tried to destroy me, and he was a police officer, Sergeant Cash. Thank God for the courts that vindicated me on that criminal in uniform. Cash, I need my money. I know you're watching. The courts say you're guilty. And president of the Softball Association, my best friend, put the dagger in me there. Had a coup d'etat on me, an illegal coup d'etat. Kai, you got $15,000 in the bank account. We don't need you anymore. We will go on and run the association without you. That crash. The Basketball Association crash. Thank God for Hurricane Dorian and the point that the chairman of Dundestan and the rest of them thiefing brogues on the board of Dundestan took $60,000. I tried to reach out to the administrator. The administrator felt threatened. I hope that they finally got rid of her because she was no good. All the people that I tried to point out that are crooks, thieves, and criminals, I got the backlash. You see, my mother said this to Kai, a good name is better to be chosen than many great riches. Most Bahamian don't give a hell about their names, their integrity, even to the point up to the prime ministers. We saw Hubert and Perry them. They had no integrity, but they were prime ministers. So why is the crime in the country the way it is? Because the younger people are looking up to Hubert, Perry, now there's other Hubert, and say, well, Kai, if they could do it, and they're calling them most honorable, I ain't got no most honorable title. I got no most honorable blue plate. And these guys are at the top in the Bahamas, and they have no integrity. So why can't and why shan't I do it? They are all about the Benjamins, the money. I've never been about that. I am about right now trying to educate through positive videos and working with Darren as my member of parliament, also a minister. Forget James. He can't even wake up in the morning without somebody helping him. So we have one member of parliament. We don't want to be another rugged island. How come? And I said this to the minister when I met with him. Why haven't we had any direct involvement in the cleanup of my and your constituency, the biggest, Central Pines, Dundestown, and Murphytown? According to the minister, that's not priority at this time. So, okay, what is priority? The grits, the flour, the sugar, the canned goods are on the dock. People brought these from Canada. I met a guy the other day from Ireland. He's Irish. You know how much flights he had to catch to come to Abaco? He don't see any movement. I saw a group I thought was Americans the other day. They're Canadians. Don't call us American. We're Canadians. We are solo pannering up. We brought solo panner. How come the government can't put, right down there by Sabasco or whatever that eatery is down West Bay Street, they have solar panels, solar panel lights down there for 10 years. How come the government of Bahamas have not moved with solar power? I was just educated this week that they have solar panel generator. In Abaco, that's impossible. How the hell you can have solar panel generators? Shouldn't the government say, look here, don't bring those diesel generators and those gas generators into Abaco? Because the people going to get killed. Those generators we're given free is a death sentence. Because when the carbon dioxide get in the house, they're dead. And they're going to be dead for days because nobody know they're in there. They run in the generator. Everybody think that the generator's cool. They're cooling off. They're chilling a little bit. They're dead from carbon dioxide poisoning. Why can the government say to the international community, send us some solar panel generator? They're more quieter. They're more cost efficient. But these are the things that I could tell Darren Handfield and the government that they don't know nothing about. Because they are consumed by the other things. But you need persons like myself on the ground that could send out information. What would be more affordable? These electrical wires, or why haven't the family islands? We got sun. 350 days of the year. Why haven't we solar panel up already with street lights? You know why? Because both FNM and PLP got these big money people, Prime Ministers Perry and Newman involved. They got investment in Focal. Focal own Esso. Focal is involved with Shell. Every time we spend a dollar on electricity, Perry, Hubert, the chairman of these big PLP parties, they getting a dollar. They don't give a hell. We are taking care of their families, their lovers and friends through the high cost electricity, the high cost of fuel. These guys have learned to live off the backs of poor Bahamians. That is the problem right now with the Haitians and the looting in Mashaba. The Haitians recognize that the people of Mashaba being treating them like slaves to the point that they don't even know their name. They call them my Haitian. That's like saying my nigger. That's saying my dog over there in the yard. They don't know their name. They just say, fetch, come, my Haitian. So they are looting and trying to take back what they think that the people, the business people of Mashaba, that stole from them their dignity. But don't bring that mess into the understand. They're going into people's houses and stealing and robbing. Then they're stooling in the closet. They're putting their feces in the bathtub in the middle of the floor. They're sending a message that we hate you because what you have done to us. They are not taught. The older Haitians have not told this generation the struggle that they inherit coming on those little boats, starting from scratch. So now these ones believe that the Bahamian people owe them something. We don't owe you nothing, buddy. We don't owe you nothing. Our government is the problem that caused you all to be here. They ought to evacuate you all right away. Now there is a major problem. That is why the problem of looting exists. Because they're fighting back against their inhumane treatment by the business people that thought they were doing them a favor by giving them a job for $150 a day. Nobody in Abaco could live on that, but that is what the business people were paying. They were paying and still paying below the government recommended wage. The government said you should pay $350 a week. They're giving them $150 all their lives. That is not acceptable. That is against the law, but it continued up until the point of Dorian had to clean up all the mess. All the thiefing from local government and understand. All the thiefing from the immigration. All the thiefing from the policemen that are trying to silence me. I wonder where they are now. I hope Commissioner send them back to Haiti. The ones that tried to discamber me and tried to hush me. I hope that they're out of Abaco and out of Abaco forevermore. But I am saying all this to say this. All hands need to be on deck. We need to say, what is the positive thing that the government has done in North Abaco to date? Somebody tell me, I will tell y'all. Until then, stay tuned because Kai is bringing positive stuff on WCAY because I'm in this like you guys are to win it. I also am an evacuee. I am also stateless, homeless, jobless to date. Stay tuned. Kai cares. That's why I'm here. I miss Abaco so much. Just to drive down Marshaba, I crave so much. You're live on WCAY.